Shall a trumpet be blown in the city, and the people not be afraid? And the people not
be afraid. Dreams. American dreams.
Awake, thou that sleepest.
Wake up.
Open your eyes.
And that knowing the time, that now it is high time to awake out of sleep.
Are we dreaming?
I can hear you.
I can hear. I can hear.
Pretend.
I hear when you
pretend that everything's okay.
It's spiritual. Shalom, family. Welcome to Shattered Paradise.
They cannot intrude here.
Somebody gotta tell the truth. And I'm gonna tell it.
Expose them.
Can it be that it was all so simple then? Memories. Nostalgia. As the storm clouds of the New World Order grow and darken our future, for most, the present is growing colder and more bitter by the day, leading many in this current generation to seek shelter and comfort by basking in the warmth of times long past. Youthful days filled with curiosity, wonder, and magic.
Magic indeed.
Magic indeed. The '80s. In recent years, the spellcasters have moved to capitalize and take advantage of a population yearning to break free and escape the unprecedented turmoil of their day. And this yearning for a simpler time has predictably fueled the American masses' insatiable appetite for all things 80s. A time before the season of judgment, the Great Reset, and the Great Awakening. Remember, ignorance is bliss, and for most, the 80s were a time of profound ignorance.
Oh yeah, we are anxiously awaiting the presents, and they're just about on their way now. The Twin Towers, and Hakim, along with the Big Boss Man.
And they are indeed towers, McMahon. Look at the size of these two.
Take it, Mean Gene.
With me at this time, the Slickster, Akeem, the African Dream, and a Big Boss Man. Gentlemen, is this the match you wanted all along, or are you going to continue your terrorist attacks on the mega powers and the defenseless Elizabeth? What do you want? All right, thank you, Vince McMahon, Hulk Hogan, Macho Man Randy Savage, the lovely Elizabeth. Three people working as one with one goal in mind, to defeat. Or should I say demolish the Twin Towers?
Ooh, yeah.
Hulk Hogan, you talked about the Triangle of Love. Jesse Ventura says there's a problem. Explain.
Well, you know, Mean Gene, you get right to the heart of the matter with that question, brother. It's the love, man, that's going to supercharge the mega powers and tear down the Twin Towers. Ooh, yeah.
Yes, man, what were your thoughts then?
Oh, yeah, Mean Gene, I can still feel the pain when that cold steel bit into Miss Elizabeth's wrist right there. And when her muscles were torn, my muscles were torn, when her bone was bruised right there, I felt the pain. Hulk Hogan felt the pain, and I can still feel the pain right now. And Hulk Hogan, that pain won't stop until the Twin Towers come crumbling down. Oh yeah, right now, tonight, on prime time, yeah.
You see, while those of us with wisdom are drawn to instinctively embrace this great awakening, for most, waking up to the truth is too shocking and disturbing. And they miss the comfort and bliss of believing in the pleasant lies that accompany deep spiritual sleep. The truth is, obeying the impulse to run and hide from the spiritual war that is all around us by immersing ourselves in entertainment and distraction is a big part of the reason we're in the situation we're in today. The 1980s were a pivotal time in the modern era, when Hasatan's kingdom really began to gain momentum right under our feet. Hidden beneath the bright neon surface of 80s pop culture, consumerism, yuppies, and Reaganomics, there was a shadowy, seedy, festering underbelly. An era of CIA drug smuggling, Iran-Contra,
the crack epidemic, the war on drugs,
mass incarceration, parents strung out, an explosion of children in foster care.
This is when the man-made bioweapon, HIV/AIDS, was unleashed. It was the Cold War era, filled with top-secret classified human experiments.
Abductions.
The faces of missing children on the back of milk cartons.
The so-called Satanic Panic.
McMartin Preschool, the West Memphis 3.
MK Ultra Mind Control, serial killer programs.
And armies of psychopaths, like Richard Ramirez, the Night Stalker, and Jeffrey Dahmer unleashed on the streets.
And he said unto them, I beheld Satan as lightning fall from heaven.
So while the spellcasters divert the people's attention with nostalgia, reminiscing on Saturday morning cartoons, colorful cereal, and their favorite childhood toys and video games,
the social engineers are hard at work, designing a subtle but irresistible trap made not only to ensnare your mind, but cage and sully your soul in a defiled transhumanoid vessel, primed for slavery. But because the Luciferian elite are utilizing the principles of lesser magic, they have to tell you. And like a vampire, they need you to open the door and let them in. We must understand that much of the predictive programming that young people watched in the 80s was preconditioning their subconscious minds to accept and bring forth the Great Reset agenda that is being rolled out today.
And the witchcraft spells we watch today are programmed to physically manifest themselves in our lives tomorrow, in the future. So it is apropos that while the baby boomers had Happy Days, the Wonder Years, and that 70s show, Generation X has been given Stranger Things.
Set in the 1980s, Stranger Things is the brainchild of 32-year-old Matt and Ross Duffer, twin brothers from North Carolina, and Jamie Wax shows us the inspiration behind the series. However, spoiler-free, Jamie, good morning to you.
Good morning, Josh. We'll try to be spoiler-free. Since its July debut, the buzz surrounding Stranger Things has only grown, in large part because of the show's 1980s nostalgia.
From the outset, Stranger Things has the look, sound, and feel of an 80s classic.
Stop it! You're freaking her out!
She's freaking me out!
Set in 1983, the show follows a group of junior high misfits on a mission to find their missing friend. Along the way, they encounter a girl with special powers named Eleven, and a gateway into another dimension. In a video posted by actress Millie Brown on Twitter, the brothers witnessed her transform into the supernatural role of Eleven.
Eleven.
Judging from the online buzz and artwork created by fans, the show already has a cult following and a gateway into another dimension.
Since 1980 and the debut of Friday the 13th, Hollywood has been letting the public know that some summer camps for children are being utilized by the shadow government to conduct secret MK Ultra mind control experiments.
Hello?
Friday, the 13th. American Horror Story 1984 premieres Wednesday at 10 on FX.
I got a gig as a counselor at a summer camp. They're opening up a couple of hours from here. Gosh, it should all come.
It's like, I feel like, do you know who Vanna White is? Maybe she's before your time.
Most people are.
Is Stranger Things based on a true story.
Yeah, actually. It is based on a place in Montauk, New York called Camp Hero. There was, like, rumors of secret government spies, like, doing human experiments to fight in the Cold War. Like,
Russians, yeah.
It's exactly what's happening in Stranger Things. And so it's based on that one government lab in Montauk, New York, which is a real place you can go visit, but you're not allowed in. Yeah. Why? Nobody knows.
Nobody knows.
How did the cast spend their summers growing up? Take a look.
Ooh,
that's a good
summer
question.
Camp. I went to lots of summer camps because both my parents worked and they were just, it's like school, but fun school.
I think I was like 12. I went away to camp.
A mysterious abandoned military base called Camp Hero. The Montauk Project. Local children were abducted off the streets, brought to the base, and subjected to brutal mind control experiments right under the now decaying Sage radar tower.
My name is Christopher Garitano, and I've been researching the Montauk Project for over 10 years. Mind control. Nazis. Aliens. And according to witnesses and alleged survivors, it all happened beneath the Camp Hero Air Force Base in Montauk, New York. According to the official story, the Camp Hero Air Force Base was a place to defend the east coast of the United States against Nazi attack during World War II. But then things get shady because after World War II, the United States recruited Nazi scientists and used them for a variety of things to develop weaponry and technology. And the people allegedly involved in the Montauk Project claim that these same Nazi scientists were brought down to Camp Hero to develop the Montauk Project. The Montauk Project is a covert government operation that illegally recruited human subjects, runaway kids, for purposes of mind control, interdimensional travel, and reverse engineering of extraterrestrial technology. But the core idea in the Montauk Project was a wrangling of human experiments. It's not fiction because we know about things like MKUltra, and we know about things like the Holmesburg prison experiments. All of these secret government mind control programs, these things have been proven. The CIA had a program called Project Stargate. Project Stargate was a remote viewing program where they had a group of people who they were training to be powerful psychics. This is a real thing. Our government funded this and actually had some success with it. And so there were hearings in 1995. Bill Clinton actually apologized for some of them.
Thousands of government-sponsored experiments did take place at hospitals, universities, and military bases around our nation. These experiments were kept secret.
In the Gregorian year of 2022, after the sporadic release of several teasers, on April 12th, the cinematic sorcerers at Netflix released the official trailer for Stranger Things Season 4.
Dear Billy, I don't know if you can even hear this. Ever since you left, everything's been a total disaster. For a while, we tried to be happy. Normal. I know that's impossible.
Located you guys far from Hawkins because I thought you'd be safe. A war is coming. I'm afraid your friends at Hawkins are very much in the eye of the storm.
I don't have my powers.
I don't know how to say this other than just to say it. Without you, we can't win this war.
See you on the other side.
On the other side.
I was convinced I was put here for some other reason. Maybe I can still help, even if it's the last thing I do.
People say Hawkins is cursed. They're not way off.
The creators of this series have forecast many agendas in previous seasons, and from the looks of this trailer, season 4 is shaping up to be no different.
First, we see the obvious CERN reference, illustrating their many failed attempts at opening a forbidden portal.
Though they want to give their audience the impression this portal is a gateway to hell, this is an esoteric inverted deception. Did Nimrod unite the whole world just so he can break into hell? The earth is already given into the hands of the wicked.
The earth is given into the hand of the wicked. He covereth the faces of the judges thereof. If not, where and who is he?
And Satan is currently the god of this world.
But if our gospel be hid, it is hid to them that are lost, in whom the God of this world hath blinded the minds of them which believe not, lest the light of the glorious gospel of Christ, who is the image of God, should shine unto them.
Well, I want to tell you now about a new discovery which is being described as the first step in a big shift in our understanding of the universe. Scientists at Fermilab, just outside Chicago, have found that the mass of a particle is not what the main theory of subatomic physics states it should be. The result has been described as shocking by the researchers because the theory has successfully predicted the behavior and properties of particles for 50 years. Well, to make sense of all the science, here's our science correspondent.
Scientists explain how the universe works using the theories of physics, but those ideas could be about to change. A particle accelerator just outside Chicago has made a measurement that could change physics forever. Researchers here have discovered that the mass of a subatomic particle called the W boson is not what it should be. And in the world of physics, that's a huge deal.
The world could look very different. It could be that the standard model as we know it is wrong or needs to be modified in some important way. It is also possible that there are other fundamental particles out there waiting to be discovered.
The standard model is one of the most important theories in physics. And in the journal Nature, the researchers say that this might be the first time it's been shown to be wrong. More experiments will be needed to confirm the result, but there have been other indications that there might be more going on in the universe than can be explained by the standard model. There have been hints of a completely new fifth force of nature from data from the Large Hadron Collider on the Swiss-French border.
What are you trying to do with this IPM? So
Dr. Mitesh Patel is among the physicists trying to explain these anomalies.
So the hope is that these cracks eventually turn into a chasm. And that not only confirms that the standard model is broken down, but gives us some idea of what the theory beyond the standard model is. And so that this data eventually develops into a new direction for how we might get a better understanding of what's at play in nature.
All eyes are now on the LHC, which is about to restart after a three-year upgrade.
The world's most powerful particle accelerator, the Large Hadron Collider, will reopen today after 3 years of being shut down for improvements. Scientists around the globe are hoping that the upgraded machine, which is massive, will be able to detect new particles and start a physics revolution that could forever change our understanding of the whole universe.
The scientists say they could be on the path to discover the gravitational forces that hold our galaxy in place, and even, potentially, miniature black holes.
There is theories out there which suggest that these microscopic black holes could be produced in high energetic proton-proton collisions. And if we indeed find first signs of these microscopic black holes, then this could open the path to new extra dimensions in our universe.
So the hope is that these cracks eventually turn into a chasm.
Their true goal is to fulfill Nimrod's dream, to reach the heavens, defeat the angelic host, and wage war against the Most High himself. And they want to harness our spiritual power to help them do it.
Old sinner man.
Where are you going to run to? Mashiach is coming.
For behold, the Lord will come with fire and with his chariots like a whirlwind, to render his anger with fury and his rebuke with flames of fire. For by fire and by his sword will the Lord plead with all flesh, and the slain of the Lord shall be many.
O sinner man,
the Messiah is coming.
Where are you going to run to? When examining anything that has to do with Hollywood, we must always keep in mind that this is an inverted reality, as above, so below, and everything in the upside down is not as it seems.
In this scene, we see an old grandfather clock, which symbolizes the New World Order's doomsday clock, and of course, the swinging pendulum harkens to the themes of hypnosis. Here, we see the character Max at her stepbrother's grave, a brother who had a supernatural hatred for the Israelites, shown by his contempt for the character Lucas, who we will show represents more than just the token black kid. 33.
Of course, the creators of this show have been initiated and various occult fraternal orders and secret societies that give them hidden knowledge. So they are privy to the various bloodlines and the curses, blessings, and prophecies that are attached to them. Though in this show, this character is named Lucas, which means bringer of light in the Greek, hearkening back to Lucifer, the light bearer. 33. this trailer also subliminally gives a not-so-subtle clue to his actual bloodline biblical identity. The only name visible in this high school basketball scene is Jacob, the patriarch of the 12 tribes, whose name was changed to Israel.
The character in this show does not know he is Jacob, an Israelite. He believes he is Lucas, an unknowing Luciferian.
Hi, Max. I'm Dustin, and this is
Lucas.
Yeah, I know.
This point is even further brought home by the fact Lucas wields a slingshot he uses to fight giants.
This is a clear reference to David, the son of Jacob, who became the king of Israel.
Oh, Satan's baby. You ever shot one of these suckers?
No. Is it sweet?
That's an understatement.
That doesn't look like a bowl.
Nah, it's way better. There is a reason this warning label says 18 or older. This sucker is filled with 150 grains of black powder, AKA gunpowder. Strap two of these together and it's bigger than an M80. Five of them? We've got ourselves a stick of dynamite.
You want to kill that thing with fireworks.
Do you have a better idea?
Yeah, 11.
Against that thing? She's gonna need some backup.
Oh my God.
The spellcasters want to harness the spiritual gifts of the Israelites to fight on behalf of their El.
Max, come on!
Lucas!
Thou art my battle axe and weapons of war, for with thee will I break in pieces the nations, and with thee will I destroy kingdoms. The spellcasters want to harness the spiritual gifts of the Israelites to fight on behalf of their El. Speaking of El.
El? Who's El?
Someone. No one.
Someone or no one?
Mount Hermon was the home of the Canaanite god El. El. El was the chief god, the creator god of the Canaanite pantheon. El was a name that came to be used in Hebrew as sort of a generic term for God. El lived in a tent. Yahweh's tabernacle was a tent. Psyop.
A psyop is absolutely right. The character in Stranger Things, known as El, supposedly short for 11, is a spiritual representation of the Canaanite goddess Ishtar.
Escaped from captivity in Hawkins' lab, she symbolizes the emancipated goddess, Lady Liberty, who is Ishtar.
The fact that the children who are test subjects in the Hawkins' lab are possessed with pagan gods and goddesses is confirmed in season 2. With the debut of another child from the experiment with superhuman abilities named Kali. Kali is the Hindu goddess of death.
Stranger Things fans suspected from the start that Elle's number 11 tattoo meant she was just one of several test subjects experimented upon at Hawkins Lab, and season 2 confirmed that with the appearance of Carly, aka number 8.
When Carly and Elle were together in season 2, they were 8-11, but there's a test subject named 9. Stranger Things season 4 could introduce 11th sister, the test subject 9, who is now free from Hawkins' lab and hellbent on revenge.
So when these two subjects are together, they are 9-11. Also, in a previous teaser for season 4, the children are shown playing chess with what can only be described as a very unusual chessboard. The pieces being made of a variety of unclean birds.
And he cried mightily with a strong voice, saying, Babylon the Great is fallen, and is become the habitation of devils, and the hold of every foul spirit, and a cage of every unclean and hateful bird.
And a cage of every unclean and hateful bird.
So it's no coincidence that the official Stranger Things brick and mortar store was placed in New York's Times Square on 42nd Street. And the same 42nd Street houses another nest for some very unclean and hateful birds.
On 42nd Street, between 3rd and 2nd Avenue, is the global headquarters of the Pfizer Corporation. Now, it's great for New York that the corporations are still in New York City. In the 50s and 60s, New York was headquarters of many, many U.S. corporations, many of the global corporations.
This is the Egyptian god Horus, the son of the winged goddess Isis. And of course, wherever Horus and Isis dwell, their scribe and messenger, Thoth, is not far behind.
The habitation of devils and the hold of every foul spirit and a cage of every unclean and hateful bird.
And because Babylon the Great is fallen, this street is also the scene of a highly symbolic spiritual sacrifice.
Miss USA Chesley Christ has died at just 30 years old. The beauty queen and lawyer passed away on Sunday morning after apparently jumping from a 60-story high-rise in Manhattan, according to police.
The end came for Chesley here at this 60-story luxury high-rise in Midtown Manhattan. Reports say Christ was last seen alive on the 29th floor terrace alone, and it is believed she jumped to her death. Authorities say she left behind a note, leaving everything to her mother.
Such an incredibly radiant light Chesley Christ was, as a correspondent for Extra Television, as a former Miss USA, a top 10 finisher in the Miss Universe pageant, and an attorney as well, dead from an apparent suicide found outside of her apartment building on 42nd Street.
Here in Hell's Kitchen. As we continue down 42nd Street through Hell's Kitchen.
That's right. Chesley Christ fell to her death from Orion's Tower to 42nd Street in Hell's Kitchen. Haunted by gerasophobia, the fear of aging, this footage shows she can feel an unclean presence stalking her, but she lacked the spiritual discernment to pinpoint who's who.
Oh my God, this creep is following us. Is he still following us?
No,
I don't want to shoot with him. It is so creepy and weird. We can just wait until he leaves. He's gonna keep following us.
Sir, we're just trying to work.
Please don't follow us. Please don't. You are following us. And it's so rude and creepy. Just keep going with your dog. We don't need you to follow us. Because you're following us. What do you mean, why do I feel uncomfortable? Because you're following us.
Well, turning now to the coronavirus pandemic in our state.
The state recorded 2,758 cases and 42 deaths.
As of today, here in Arkansas, there are 996 people fighting COVID in a hospital, 33 less than yesterday's total. Unfortunately, 42 more deaths were reported, bringing the total to 4,784.
State of Minnesota today reported 42 new COVID-19 related deaths, along with 12,722 new coronavirus cases.
Thanks, Chris. Michigan reports another 42 deaths and 2,500 cases linked to COVID-19.
The coronavirus story is our top focus this hour, as mainland China has now reported 42 new deaths.
Well, 1,504 new cases of COVID-19 have been reported across the country. The health department has also reported a further 42 COVID-19 related deaths.
L's 11 actually represents the two pillars of Freemasonry, one male and one female, just as the two pillars in the Tree of Life symbol of Kabbalah are synthesized into one androgynous singularity, illustrated by the Twin Towers' destruction on 9/11 and their subsequent amalgamation into the One World Trade Tower. Though L presents as mostly female, just as the goddess Columbia and Lady Liberty, they are all actually just different representations of the same androgynous being. In this scene, serenaded by the 80s stadium rock band Journey, singing "Here We Stand, Worlds Apart, Hearts Broken in Two," while showing the scene transition from America to Russia.
It becomes clear the sorcerers are planning to repeat the 9/11 ritual on an even larger scale. America and her allies being the feminine pillar, and Russia and its allies the masculine pillar. The synthesis of the two will be the One World Government, New World Order, Beast System, order out of chaos.
And the 10 horns which thou sawest are 10 kings, which have received no kingdom as yet, but receive power as kings 1 hour with the beasts. These have one mind, and will give their power and strength unto the beast. These shall make war with the Lamb, and the Lamb shall overcome them, for he is Lord of lords and King of kings, and they that are with him are called and chosen and faithful. And he saith unto me, The waters which thou sawest, where the whore sitteth, are peoples, and multitudes, and nations, and tongues. And the 10 horns which thou sawest upon the beast, these shall hate the whore, and shall make her desolate and naked, and shall eat her flesh, and burn her with fire. For God hath put in their hearts to fulfill his will, and to agree, and give their kingdom unto the beast, until the words of God shall be fulfilled. And the woman which thou sawest is that great city, which reigneth over the kings of the earth.
This scene shows the protagonist characters, their initiation as light bearers, in the image of their goddess, Lady Liberty, Ishtar. At the 1 minute 59 second mark, after the title card, a millisecond one-frame flash illuminates the screen, revealing a secret occult message, 6 portals and 4 timestamps.
What could this cryptic riddle mean?
Expose them.
Each of these time codes correspond with 4 different scenes from the trailer. Chronologically, these are the frames we see at these times. In the first portals, timestamped at 33 seconds, we see 3 different letters highlighted, I, A, and M, spelling I am. The second portal illuminates the hell on Mike's Hellfire Club t-shirt. The subsequential portal is placed over the S and Lenora Hills, and the final portal is framed over Eddie's Dungeons & Dragons book, highlighting the word Master.
So the complete message reads, I am Hell's Master.
This message leads to a secret official Netflix website where you find a countdown, and for those that register, they are sent this email, which leads to,
have nothing to do with the fruitless deeds of darkness, but rather expose them.
Now, you might be thinking, what does baseball have to do with Stranger Things? It's all spiritual.
Baseball greats gathered in Times Square to celebrate the legendary player who paved the way for them, Jackie Robinson.
75 years ago today, in Brooklyn, New York, 9 miles from here, he broke the color barriers.
April 15th, 1947, 28-year-old Robinson debuted for the Brooklyn Dodgers, a day that changed baseball and the course of history.
Jackie showed the world that equality should be a fundamental right for all, and that real change in our society was possible.
Jackie Robinson Way.
This Jackie Robinson Day, his name will be displayed on a street sign for all to see passing 42nd and Broadway. And his number, 42, will shine on the iconic Empire State Building, just like he did in so many ways.
This year, sacrifices to the cage of hateful birds have been numerous, carried out by the foul Thoth Hermes.
Sadness looms over this Forest Hills neighborhood following the death of 51-year-old Orsalia Gall, a wife and mom of 2 sons found dead on Metropolitan Avenue near the Jackie Robinson Parkway. Out of all places, a duffel bag, according to police. Police say a man walking his dog spotted the duffel bag on the side of the roadway Saturday morning shortly after 8 o'clock.
Dave and Buster's on 42nd Street, one man, according to police, pulled out some kind of sharp object and stabbed the victim. He was taken to the hospital, where he was pronounced dead.
It's also important to note that the Hellfire Club was an actual secret society, which one of the so-called founding fathers, Benjamin Franklin, was a member of.
A fact that is conveniently left out of many accounts of the excavation of human remains from beneath Benjamin Franklin's house is that all the bones belong to so-called black people, Israelites.
See you on the other side.
On the other side.
Again, the phrase "see you on the other side" is a reoccurring theme we are seeing in greater frequency as we get closer to the event. For a breakdown on the symbolism in this scene, please check out one of our latest in-depth uncensored presentations, Who's Who. This video, Who's Who, exposes hidden truths that are prohibited to speak of by YouTube's controllers, so please consider supporting our work. This video is available on our website and Patreon.
In the last sequence of the trailer, they reveal season 4's main antagonist. A villain from the Upside Down, waging war on not only the show's heroes, but the 2 world superpowers, America and Russia.
In a teaser listing all the titles of season 4's episodes, we see that the 2nd episode is named Vecna's Curse. This is an exoteric cover story that Vecna is just a character inspired by Dungeons & Dragons lore. But when one examines the attributes of this entity, it is clear there is a deeper and more profound esoteric meaning. In one of season 4's teasers, titled Krill House, after a family moves into a home haunted by the so-called Vecna spirit, we see a rabbit lying on the lawn with his left eye plucked out.
Vecna's known to possess his victims, causing them to gouge out their eye and cut off their hand.
Expose them.
So being that this is the inverted, upside-down world of Hollywood spellcasting, identifying the true identity of who their villain is supposed to symbolize is not hard to discern.
Expose them.
Who instructed some of their followers to choose to pluck out one of their eyes or cut off one of their hands in order to cross over into his domain?
If your hand causes you to sin, cut it off. It is better for you to enter life maimed than with two hands to go into hell, where the fire never goes out. And if your eye causes you to sin, pluck it out. It is better for you to enter the kingdom of God with one eye than to have two eyes and be thrown into hell.
Though we know there is no enchantment against Jacob and no divination against Israel, because of our transgressions, we are not able to walk in this blessing until the elect come into the fold and repentance comes to its full.
Unfortunately, we are hindered by the two-thirds Israelites, and some of them know right from wrong, but choose wrong because they love the money and they love Babylon. Repentance can come to someone at the final hour. Some laborers may show up to the vineyard late, but still receive the same wage.
The bottom line is that when all is said and done, the Most High Yahuwah will have his vengeance and victory, and none of these foolish Nimrods can stop the kingdom. In closing, we must pray that we be granted the spiritual discernment and Holy Spirit-inspired vigilance, so we will be able to see things as they truly are and not just as they appear to be.
And at that time shall Michael stand up, the great prince which standeth for the children of thy people. And there shall be a time of trouble such as never was since there was a nation even to that same time. And at that time thy people shall be delivered, every one that shall be found written in the book. And many of them that sleep in the dust of the earth shall awake, some to everlasting life, and some to shame and everlasting contempt. And they that be wise shall shine as the brightness of the firmament, and they that turn many to righteousness as the stars forever and ever.
After a series of unexplainable file disappearances, hardware failures, and the suspicious crash of our main hard drive, we have returned to deliver a message that some very powerful entities, whether carnal or spiritual, do not want us to deliver. So at long last, we are excited to be able to present our latest video presentation, Lust in War. Through a painstaking process of digital search and retrieval, we've been able to rebuild and recreate this very important message piece by piece. So in this first installment, we invite you to join our research and discernment community as we decode and expose the secret signs and symbols hidden in plain sight, symbols that forecast the enemy's next move. If you would like to support our work and view our latest presentation, Lust in War, is now available on our Patreon and websites. The links are in the description box below. Thank you for your support.